ladies and gentlemen, y'all already know what time it is, man. If you like the video, subscribe for more daily 2K content, and let's get right into it. NBA 2K21, they dropped a bombshell on us yesterday, man. We didn't get any really news, but Mike, he was talking about yesterday how the game is, well, some of the things that we can expect, and we actually got some real gameplay. Now, albeit from a camera angle that we really didn't like, but you know, it is what it is. You got to take what you can get. Beggars cannot be choosers. But I got the best subs on YouTube because my subs pointed out a couple of things that they wanted us to be wary of, you know, in the next gen system. So you know, and it wasn't just Brandon Zennings. It was Brandon Ingram. Dude said, I'm convinced dude is joking at this. Hey, of course I am, man. I'm always doing stuff. But anyway, check it out, man. Look, they pointed out a couple of things that they were concerned about. I myself am concerned as well. I want to point it out to you guys. I want us to take a look at it and let me know what y'all think. So let me know before we get started, was the video a W or a L? Like the video because it helps me get into algorithm, and I'll be back with y'all in 1 sec. Nino!
If you make it to C25, that's OG status. I was told you could be anything, just don't be average. Down bad, flat pockets, that shit made me a savage. Start hustling nonstop, don't plan on breaking that habit.
All right, so just looking at this whole thing, man, I think the whole thing with the graphics, it's a W. I'm not going to lie to you. The graphics are exquisite. You can see the foot planting. You can see all this stuff, man. And a lot of the stuff that people were thinking, like the game is just going to look so much better, it does look better, right? It does look better. I think we can all agree with that. Some of the things that you guys may not notice, I do notice, because I notice all the reflections on the floor, all that good stuff right there because of the ray tracing, right? Ray tracing, I'm pretty sure you guys know what the ray tracing is. Ray tracing is just where light, they can better do lighting. That's pretty much the best way for me to take, because if I try to break it all the way down, it's not going to be. You see the reflections and stuff that weren't there before in the other games? That's what ray tracing is. That's all I can tell you. You can take a ray of light, trace where it came from, blah, 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 and project it where it needs to go. That's how it is in a nutshell. So that's why we got better lighting, and that's a lot of part of making something look real. It's the lighting. You can really light things, you can see the blemishes on people's faces. You can see the tone in the muscles. You can see the stuff in the neck. All this stuff. You can see how cut they are. All that good stuff, man. They can do different stuff like that. Now, a lot of people thinking that the game is going to look so much better, but do you want the game to really look real like Mortal Kombat with straight body scans and move scans or what have you? Or do you want it to be the best looking game that they can get computer generated? Y'all let me know down in the comment section. What do you want? Do you want it to look absolutely real, like just real players out there, real scanned faces? Or do you want it to look as real as a computer generated game can look? I prefer the latter because the latter is limitless. And, you know, if we go with the real life, and we kind of bound by the rules of real life and stuff like that. So I prefer the latter because you got endless possibilities. I want to see the best game that we can get as the computer generated game can put out. But like I said, the game looks good, and the extra processing power is not always going to go to how good the game can look. A lot of times the extra processing power goes to things in the background, like how they finally worked out foot planting, how they say they got more responsive AI, how they got the AI that moves a little bit better. You got stuff in the background with the crowd and all this stuff. So a lot of times that extra processing power that you don't have to use for the ray tracing, because it would take a hell of a computer to pull this off years ago. And if you want to see ray tracing more, look, I'm gonna be running GTA tonight on Twitch, the ray tracing mod, and you know, we're gonna check that out, and I'll show y'all how that looks, man. I got a RTX 2060 Super. I want to get that 3070 tomorrow, man. I'm gonna try to get it, but I might not be able to, who knows. If you're gonna get the RTX 3070 or the 3080 or the 3090, let me know down in the comment section which one you're gonna get. But anyway, we already talked too long about this. Like I said, ray tracing just gives the game more depth, makes it look more real, and I think that we're gonna see more increases in the graphical fidelity going forward with these games. Cause I gotta talk the game up. Mike Dem did a great job on this. I'm not even gonna lie to you. They did an awesome job on how the game looks. And you know, with the expressions in people's faces, it's real-time expressions. You don't get like expression and then cutaway and then another expression. I hope that's something that gets to translate to all my players. But like I said, I would be remiss if I did not point out a couple of things that my subs wanted me to point out. And we just gonna get right into it. Don't y'all love these trans? Don't y'all just love these trans? I can do this stuff, man. Look, my sub said, Jay, this appeared to be, we were running the same play over and over for a reason. This appears to be an ordinary three ball. by Klay Thompson. But let's run it back. I just want to run it all the way. It looks like an ordinary three ball by Klay Thompson, but upon further review, boom, we're going to zoom in. Look at what's going on right here. What is this vacuumular action? Look at Brandon Zennings. Didn't write that shit. Anyway, Brandon Zennings. Look, what is this vacuumular action that's going on here? He's going to beat him. He's by him. And then he said, nope, you missed the screen, my boy. I need to get over here. Snatches him back. And then he gets to go out. Actually, what happens is he snatches him back. And then somebody takes control of him because they're like, uh-oh, somebody go catch this vacuum screen. And then, he goes on out there. Now, I don't understand why we're even seeing this, even in this. Maybe this is an early alpha or something like that, and this is not the final game, and they have not put in the anti-vacuum screen joint in here. But I'm just saying, we were told that we would not see this, and I think that this is literally the most egregious offense of a vacuum screen that we've ever seen. He's literally by him, like Klay is going one way, right? Oh, and he actually hits two people with the screen, right? So Draymond, of course it's Draymond setting the screen, man, one of them Draymond screens. But look, he comes by, he runs wide on the screen because he knows where he's gonna go. I got my joint right here. Yeah, here we go. He runs wide on the screen. He runs this way on the screen. That's your boy. And then Drew Holiday is gonna run here, and he plans to meet him right here. This is what he wants to do. So you got Klay going high, and then he's gonna go low, and he's planning to meet him at the spot, right? That's what's supposed to happen. And for the most part, that is what happens. But look at that. He beats him. He's through it. And he said, nah, brother, you getting screened. And so he snatches him back, and he's like, oh, shoot. He takes control, and, like Janet Jackson. And once by the time he takes control, the shot is already off, man. Now, like I said, in real time, if we look at this in real time, you probably missed it, because I definitely missed it. But my guy in the comments section, he didn't miss it. He's like, whoop, whoop, whoop. Like, bro, like, this is an egregious offense, bro. Like, look at that. What is he? I don't even understand what he's trying to do. Like, there's nothing other than, I was thinking, well, maybe he just tried to go that way under it to meet him, but there's no reason for him to do that. The AI, supposed to have more processing power. We're supposed to have more everything. I don't get it. I don't get why that happens. Gets out there hella late. Maybe they did that to set it up so that he could get an open shot or what have you, and maybe they wouldn't have been able to get off an open shot otherwise. I don't know. But that's a pretty egregious offense. Now, this is a lesser offense, but I do want to talk about it and touch on it real quick. Because right here, like we said, I actually pointed this out in the video. He sets the screen, and he actually went under the screen, so he didn't get vacuumed into it. Like, he said it. It's actually there. He led him into the screen. Because that, okay, you see, this is what I always say. This is an away screen. You see right here? This is what's called an away screen. The guy, like, he's at least what? We'll say like 3 feet, 3 feet away from him here. And then Lonzo is going to lead him into it. And then he should hit the screen right here. But that's what's going to happen. Like, that's what we call an away screen. He didn't just walk up to him, set a screen, and like he's humping him or something like that. Like a horny dog or anything like that. So, boom. He sets the away screen. Boom. Well, actually, I guess he didn't set the away. No. It is set. He's just moving into it. So, boom. He stops moving right here. It's a little away screen. He leads him into it. He goes around. But the thing that bothers me the most is what happens after the screen. Throw the alley. Right! Now, I get it. This is Steph Curry, and they did play this right. Like, he didn't get caught by the screen. Goes around. Here we go. Both Draymond and both of those guys commit. I don't know why you commit that hard to Lonzo, because he's not known for shooting off the dribble. And then they get back. Now, he did get back late. Zion is already on cloud 9, and yes, he is getting put in the rim. That's what should happen. What I'm worried about is what will happen in the future when we have somebody of similar size down there. It's the same thing going to happen because it's already ridiculously easy to throw alleys. Like me and Swante were talking about the other day, people are already making pure reds just so they have that automatic bailout play. And I just don't like this. I don't like what it might be. I'm wondering, are the alleys fixed? And are these true contact alleys that when you get over there late or something like that, you're gonna get dunked on? I get that. I totally get that. Or is this gonna be a situation where they don't know how to fix something in the game and they can't fix it and they're covering it up with an animation? That's the part I don't want to see. I don't want, like this right here, this is fine. He got there late, it's a contact alley, and it's like, it just pulled him in, like, he otherwise, he's not even involved in the play, really, and he's gonna get dunked on. But right now, we got too many people. I'm standing in between the guy and the person, and he throws the alley anyway. He doesn't care. He throws the alley with impunity. He throws it, dude just motion shifts through me or motion shifts me out the way, and he still gets it. And really, the only way to stop alleys is if the game allows you to, you can jump up there and knock it down. You can jump and cuff block it, or the game may just allow you to be in a position and it'll recognize that you're already there and the person just won't even, they won't go up. But with contact alleys, are they gonna just go up anyway and dunk on you and they're just gonna cover it up with an animation? So it's something that's been in the game, plaguing the game for the last 3 years and you can't stop it and they're gonna cover it up with an animation? Or are we gonna fix this? Backdoor alleys are fine. When you catch somebody, flat-footed, you go backdoor, alley-oop, boom. Alley-oops off the curl are fine. As long as that paint is clear and there's a crack of space, I'm cool with it. But when you got guys literally standing there playing the alley, and no matter what they do, they can't stop it, it's a problem. Anyway, man, that's all I wanted to talk about here real quick, man, with you guys, man. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think down in the comment section. Do you think alleys are broken? Are you getting that 3070? Is it a W or L? I think that the things that they did, I think it's a W, man. Like I said, the graphical fidelity, all that stuff looks good, and everything is not going to transfer to just being better graphics. A lot of stuff is just processing power in the background, and they have the ability to do more. And you know, it's like you got a bigger engine. You know, that don't mean you're going to go 150 miles an hour, but you can hit it if you need to, or you can do 0 to 60 in like 3 seconds. But you know what I'm saying? Like you just got more house to deal with, right? You're not going to sleep in all 16 rooms at one time, but hey, you can do different things in different rooms. That's probably a better analogy. Anyway, I got to get up out of here, man. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'm holler at y'all next time. Till next time, leave a like. It's your boy Jay Easy, aka Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Godspeed! Commence. It don't make cash and it don't make sense, cause we can't pay rent with no one's opinion. So in that sense, I never value your 2 cents. Heck, darn. Please leave that bullshit you speak at the barn, cause I ain't buying. I'm only 5'8", that's fine, nigga. I could give a heart transplant to a giant. I ain't lying. Godspeed. Godspeed. We good.